Did you enlist or were you drafted?
I enlisted.
How old were you and why did you want to go to war?
I had reached my 21st birthday. I was working on a farm for $35 a month. I thought, I'm not getting anywhere this way. I might as well join the service. It's going to get me anyhow. If I join the Air Force, I've got a good chance of doing something, not expecting to fly.
What year was that?
41. Yeah, 41. I wanted to join the Air Corps. And I did that. Got into the Air Corps. And I had a friend talk me into going to cadets. And I made it, and he didn't. I got shot at, and he didn't. That's the way it turned out.
Well, sure. So tell me what your experience was in the war. Where were you when you were captured? Because you were a prisoner of
We're
war.
deep in Germany, over Augsburg, about 3 hours from home. And we lost an engine over the target, and we were straggling, and a fighter picked us off, knocked out all my controls. I have no control. There's not much to do. As we always put it, get out and walk.
So you were you flying at the time?
Oh yes. I was the first pilot. And so I just gave the bailout order, and we all took to the chutes.
So you
And
parachuted down.
yep.
What happened when you got on the ground? Were you able to run and try and get away?
No, none of us did. I think it was in April, so there were people out in the fields. I landed probably 100 feet from a couple of ladies in the field, and a soldier running over the hill took charge of me. And I'm not sure about the other members of my crew, but they were all captured immediately.
I see. And what year was that then?
That was
April
April of 44.
44. Okay. How long were you held captive then?
13 months. Well, compared to some people, it was short.
How did the Germans treat you as an American?
I can't complain of my treatment. I was never mistreated. I had enough to eat. I didn't starve. But also, I think I wound up in the best prison camp in Germany, which was, well, most of the air prisoners were handled by the Luftwaffe. And they took a little better care of us than ground personnel.
I heard from someone else too that the Germans had a lot of respect for airmen
They
and treated
did.
them better
They did.
too.
Especially the Luftwaffe. The others probably weren't, but the Luftwaffe did.
And Luftwaffe, was that the name of the camp
That's
you're
the
at?
German Air Force.
So they treated you well, you had enough to eat, some did they make you do any work at all?
Oh no, an officer would not work. They abided by the Geneva Convention that well. No officers worked. The GIs, the enlisted men, I think a lot of them had to work, but possibly not all of them. But they were in different prison camps too. We were separated into different camps.
What was the name of the camp?
I was in Stalag Luft 1. Stalag is prison, Luft is air. Air prison, number one. We had a lot of sports provided basically by the Red Cross and so on. And we had a pretty good little library too. I read a lot of books while I was there. And we always had some games going on in a warmer weather, of course. Winter, probably not so much. But there was quite a few things to do. I sang in a chorus over there. I had never sung with a group in my life, but I liked to sing. We had a chorus of 60 to 80 men. We sang the Messiah for Christmas over there. I'd never heard of the Messiah at that time. And they somehow got a hold of the music, and we sang it, just that big chorus. It was beautiful.
Having such good treatment, I guess you could say, within the camp, how did you feel towards Nazi Germans?
Well, yeah. I wouldn't say we had any antagonism toward them because they were doing their job. We did ours until they captured us. To go back a step, we shot down the pilot that shot us down. He went out at 12 o'clock, which is toward the head of us. And my bombardier shot him down with the nose to it. I met him in the hospital. He had a 50 caliber crease right down the side of his head. Came that close to getting it. We shook hands. No antagonism. He was doing his job. We were doing ours. So I wished I could have kept track of him and had his name after the war. 10-1 that he probably didn't survive the war. I did. Because he went back to flying probably. I went to prison camp where they weren't shooting at me anymore.
So you were safer?
I thought so, yeah.
So did you have, at that time you were 21 when you enlisted, were you married at that time or did you have a girlfriend?
I was married in Texas before I went overseas.
Did she know that you were captured?
Not for, they didn't know I was, they knew I was missing after about 2 or 3 weeks. And then they didn't know I was a prisoner or alive for 2 or 3 months. I'm not sure that time. And but we had no mail contact for 4 or 5 months. And after that, we had some mail back and forth. So we knew what was going on, and they knew. They didn't know where I was, but they just knew I was in hands of the Germans in prison camp, of course.
That had to have been so scary, particularly those first 4 or 5 months for them, not knowing if you're alive or dead.
I think it was much harder on the family at home than it was on us, because once we were down and alive, we felt secure in a way. We weren't afraid of the Germans. We didn't expect to be mistreated too much. Where at home, their big concern was, did he survive or not? And more of them probably didn't survive than did. I heard just the other day that the survival rate of a air crew flying 25 missions was about 25%. That's not too good odds.
How many missions did you fly on before you were shot down?
26. I had one more to go. I'd been all done. Could have been back home or possibly sent to the Pacific.
When did you come back to the United States? What year was that?
In July 45.
Tell me about your welcome home celebration.
Honestly, I don't remember a whole lot of it. Except my wife, she didn't wait for me to get to Watertown, where I lived. She came to Minneapolis to meet me. Celebrated our second anniversary and my recovery home, back home.
Oh, that's fat. So it had to be the best anniversary you've had over all these
years. Probably so, yeah.
Is she still alive now?
No.
I'm sorry.
We had 38 years together and she passed away.
I'm sorry. When you came back, did you get back into farming then?
I went to work for Nellis Chalmers Agency that I had worked for while I was working and going to high school. And I worked there for 4 years and then decided to go farming and farmed the rest of my life then.
So when you came back, was it hard for you to talk about your experience and what you had gone through at all?
No, not really. I never had any problem talking about it. Some of them did, but I did not. My co-pilot did not like to talk about it, but as the years went by, he realized his family should know what he'd gone through, and he opened up. They all know the story details now, and he is still alive in Nebraska.
Do you still have a lot of your friends from that time around and with you?
Oh, yes. I belong to the 96th Bomb Group Association, 8th Air Force Association. So I've been to a few reunions and met a few friends. And have one classmate right here. One of my cadet classmates is in the group here today.
So I've always heard that airmen have a lot of pride about their planes. Tell me about your plane that you were flying in World War II.
Strangely enough, whatever plane you flew was the best plane they ever made. But the B-17 Flying Fortress had a reputation that stands until even today. So we loved it, and it took a beating to still come home.
What went through your head when you were up there in the air dropping bombs on those 26 missions you made it through?
To stay out of the way of those fighters. And thank the Lord for getting us through the flak without being hit too badly. I never went over a target without praying. That was essential, I thought. You can't be an atheist, be up there and any more than you could in the foxhole. You had to have some faith to become, even faith that even though I didn't make it back, I survived it. And that's great. But some days it was pretty rough, there's no doubt about it. You'd see a lot of fighters. Sometimes the flak over the target was terrible. You wondered how you ever got through it. Sometimes we slid home, that home was hardly a touch. And again, we'd be hit pretty hard and still make it home. We had a couple experiences that really shook us, but we made it back home. So we thought we were invincible after that, but we weren't.
Thought you were invincible until the next mission.
Well, until that last one, anyhow. Yeah. Yes, I for some reason, I always had a feeling I would make it through and always get back. And I did.
Without even any wounds, too.
Right. Never touched anything. Yet, this one man that I had killed, he had a premonition he would not come back. And everybody seemed to know that, the way he felt. So he knew kind of what was ahead of him. Strange, the fact that I survived that many missions. Some little quaint things, my co-pilot, when we were bailed out, our chutes were under our seat. He reached down and grabbed his by the wrong handle. Popped his chute right between us. The last I saw of him, he was gathering that up in his arms and he jumped out. He's still alive today. It opened. When I got to prison camp, walked in the prison camp on my 24th birthday, right inside the gates was some friends of mine that I'd graduated with, standing there waiting for me.
So it was a reunion for your birthday and you could have a party.
Right. Yeah.
That's great.
A lot of strange things happen. But overall, then I felt that for me, the war was over. I felt I'd survived it. I wasn't being shot at anymore. I use the term, a lot of times people ask me how it was. I said I had a paid vacation. I wasn't worrying about a thing anymore, really. We didn't know the atrocities that the Germans had done at that time. That wasn't known until after the war. But that was not to prisoners, that was to the Jews, basically, you know.
So you didn't know that at the time?
No. We didn't know about those concentration camps. No, that was all came afterwards. That was quite a surprise.
Did you view Hitler as a tyrant, a dictator, a horrible person like he's known now?
Yes, we did. We had no consideration for anything good out of him. And of course, even in prison camp, we knew what was going on. We had a radio. The Germans couldn't find it, but they'd keep searching for it, but they never found it.
So you're able to keep up on what was happening?
We knew the news all the time. We knew what was going on at the BBC radio out of England. And we had a map on the wall showing where the front was. We knew how far away the Americans were. And we knew what Hitler was saying and doing. And we knew he was in some way, I'd say he was a tyrant, of course, but I think he was also a coward.